Howdy again everyone, and today is a happy day for me. One of my favourite focal lengths in the world is 20mm on a full frame camera, and where options were once scarce, they're now offered by almost all the major manufacturers, and today I get to review the Nikon Z20mm f1.8S. It's only for their full frame mirrorless Z mount cameras, or the APS-C ones, and it's typically expensive for a Nikon lens, costing around $1,000 in the US, or about £1,000 here in the UK. That is cheap for an f1.8 lens for sure, but then again, these new Nikon lenses tend to offer pretty spectacular image quality. Well, we'll see about that in a minute. I'd like to thank Nikon UK for loaning me a copy of this lens for testing, although as usual, this is a totally independent review. I love 20mm lenses because they give you a dramatically wide angle of view with lovely stretched corners, which is very useful for landscape photography and architecture shots, among many other things, but it's not such a wide angle that it just becomes difficult to compose your images, or you lose track of your subject as it's pushed far away into your picture. A maximum aperture here, as bright as f1.8, means the lens will be very useful for shooting in dark situations or indoors, and can also offer you slightly out of focus backgrounds, particularly if you get up close and personal to your subject. Cool. The lens itself has excellent build quality, on a par with Nikon's other Z mount lenses, and it's quite a simple thing really. It weighs 0.5kg, or a little over a pound. The front part of its body is made of heavy duty plastic. The rear section of the lens, including the mount, is made of metal with markings etched into the side and a weather sealing gasket around the edge. The lens has an auto manual focus switch followed by a metallic customizable focus ring which turns smoothly. It's preset to act as a full-time manual focus ring, although you can also set it on your camera to control your aperture, your exposure compensation, or your ISO sensitivity. As a manual focus ring, it works nice and responsively. As you can see here, you see a moderate amount of focus breathing with this lens. The lens's autofocus motor is very quiet, emitting a barely audible whirring sound. It works quite quickly and accurately. It has a 77mm filter thread around the front of it, which is nice and convenient for landscape photography. It also comes with a plastic, petal-shaped lens hood. The lens does not feature image stabilization, but Nikon's cameras are mostly image stabilized themselves now. Overall, no problems in build quality here at all. It handles very nicely, although its shape is a little odd looking, being so long and thin. Well, anyway, let's move on and look at image quality. I'm testing this lens on a Nikon Z7 with its full frame 45MP sensor. In-camera corrections are turned on. At f1.8, contrast is excellent and sharpness is almost perfect, almost. Let's look over inner corners. They look a little darker, but sharpness and contrast are still excellent, although still not quite perfect. Let's top down to f2.8. Brightness and contrast see a great improvement here, although sharpness is about the same. However, the middle of the image is now completely razor sharp. F4 is just as good in the middle of your image, you can't improve on perfection, and the corners look virtually perfect too now. The lens stays this sharp down to f11. Stop down further and softness will begin to creep in from the effects of diffraction. So, a star performance here, its image quality is truly excellent straight at f1.8 and becomes completely perfect as you stop down. You can't ask for much more than that. Now, let's take a look at distortion and vignetting. These cameras were taken with in-camera corrections turned off. We see some moderate barrel distortion here, nothing dramatic though. At f1.8, vignetting is quite strong, those corners look a bit dark. Stop down to f2.8 and the corners brighten up a lot, and that's about as bright as they get. So, it's a pretty average performance here for distortion and vignetting, so keep your corrections turned on. The lens can focus as closely as 20cm to your subject, just about close enough for capturing smaller subjects. At f1.8, the close-up image quality is a little softer than before, but still quite usable. Stop down to f2.8 for perfect image quality to re-emerge when you're shooting close-up. Now, let's see how the lens works against bright light. It's an averagely good performance. We see some light flaring and a touch of glaring, but nothing that creates any kind of serious problem. While we're working in the dark, let's take a look at coma levels, especially as this lens has some real potential for astrophotography. At f1.8, bright lights in the image corners see a touch of smearing, but nothing too bad. That is reduced at f2.8 and gone at f4. Let's zoom out a bit to look at the sun star situation. You need to stop down to f8 or f11, or even better, f16, to get some reasonably sized sun stars here. And finally, bokeh. No real problems here, out-of-focus backgrounds look nice and smooth overall, and even in very difficult backgrounds, the lens puts up a good show. So, overall, this is a seriously excellent lens. It is brilliantly sharp, notably better than Nikon's 24mm lens I tested a while ago, and all its other optical properties are at least on the good side of average. It'll make itself useful for all kinds of work, and although you do have to pay top dollar for this one, you at least get the performance to match. It's a beautiful and accomplished lens, so for its current price of $1,000, it certainly does come recommended, and if that price ever goes down even just a little, then it's highly recommended.